Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and many of you have been asking me to do a What's on My iPad video. So this is the What's on My iPad mid-2019. I only do a few of these a year, usually at the beginning or the middle of the year, sometimes at the end. And as you can see, I have iPad OS or iPad OS 13 on here, and this is my normal layout. Now, I normally don't fill out the bottom row. It just seems more organized to me that way. It's just the way I have it on my iPad, and I only use a couple different pages here. So you'll see I have most of my mainly used or mostly used apps on the main page, and then I move everything off to the second page. Now, this is a little bit disorganized, but I mostly use Google apps on my iPad when it comes to things like watching video with YouTube or Google News or just Google here. And honestly, I don't feel there's any really good Android tablets. I know there's some Samsung ones out there. I prefer the iPad. I think it's much, much better than really anything out there as far as tablets are concerned. And I can edit video on it. So as you can see, we have some things here. Find My, all the stock Apple apps. But if we go into shopping, Amazon, B&H Photo for all my video gear, like the camera I'm using here, and then also eBay. Now, I haven't used this app in a while, but Day One is a journaling app that I use. I really like it, but I haven't used it in a while. But my favorite folder on here that I don't use enough is my video creation folder. This is everything I need in order to create a video, edit it, use my iPhone to film it, whatever I want to do. This folder contains all of that. So oftentimes, if I'm using my iPhone to film a video, I can actually use Filmic Pro, and then Filmic Remote on the iPad is a remote viewer. So this becomes my screen so I can see what my iPad or my iPhone sees. So because the iPhone might be at an awkward angle to see the display, I can use Filmic Remote to do that. And then also, Pixelmator Photo is what I use to edit all of my photos. Actually, I use Pixelmator Pro on the Mac most of the time, but Pixelmator Photo will do the same thing on the iPad for the most part. And then, of course, for video editing, until there's a Final Cut Pro, there's LumaFusion, and this is very full-fledged. You can see I actually did mess around with editing the Apple CarPlay video on here. I was going to edit it and decided not to, but you'll see it's fully capable of playing back 4K video, no problems. And you can edit it, change LUTs or whatever you want to do. It's quite full-fledged. And there's a few different things that I'm missing that I use on Final Cut. Hopefully they'll get added in here. Now I just hit low battery. My battery on my iPad, in case you're wondering, we'll go down to battery here. And you'll see over the last 10 days, I actually haven't used it a ton lately, but 1 hour and 32 minutes of screen on time yesterday for watching videos, a couple hours the previous day, just depends on the day, what I'm doing with it. And then a lot of screen off time, but you'll see 53% of my activity is actually YouTube. So I do use YouTube quite a bit on here. In fact, that's what I use the most if I'm not looking for news or researching new videos with Safari. So I've been using Google Tasks a little bit. I go back and forth between reminders, notes, and Google Tasks. I go between all of those depending on what I'm doing. And then I have Motor Trend here. There's a show on there that I watch. I watch a lot of automobile or car shows. And then there's your normal pages, Keynote, and Numbers if I need them. Things I have not used that much, especially with that new Reminders app. And then Gmail. I don't think Mail does a good enough job with Gmail or Google Mail, so I use Gmail instead. And then, of course, the feedback and Twitter. I'm on Twitter all the time, talking throughout the day. Now, on the second page, there's some other apps. Finance, we're not going to go into, but there's some more photo editing apps. I don't use a whole lot. Google Photos for some things. Pixelmator instead of Pixelmator Photo, and then all the Apple apps. These just go in a folder if I don't use them on my device normally. And then entertainment, you'll see there's a few here. When there's a new show that I want to watch, I'll go in and watch something, maybe something on Amazon Prime, like The Grand Tour, something like that. And then games. Some of these I don't really play a whole lot. Sometimes I do. I played through all the different room games. Portal or Bridge Constructor Portal, Monument Valley 2. If they're on here, I've probably played them a lot, except for Minecraft. That's typically for videos like this, as well as Fortnite. I don't really play Fortnite. I'm more of an old school video gamer when it comes to that. A lot of Battlefield 5, Call of Duty, PC games, all sorts of things. Sim games like SimCity or Cities Skyline. I play that a lot, so not so much on the iPad. Now, as far as Lumix Sync, that's for this camera. Again, this is a Panasonic S1 I'm using. Sometimes I use a Panasonic GH5. You can remote view what you're seeing through the camera. And then utilities, Geekbench, of course, for different videos like this, speed test for internet speed, password management, and then Anchor for podcasts. I've been considering doing a podcast. I did one a long time ago. I'll probably do one again soon. PDF expert. I think I needed to mess around with PDFs a little more than the iPad could do before iOS 13 or iPad OS. And so I installed that. I haven't used it since. You can see it's not even open. Eero for managing my home Wi-Fi. That's what I use there. And then the bottom row, I use a little bit depending on what it is. And I was looking for different cell phones and things on OfferUp. And that's really it. There's not much more to go into. LumaFusion's great if you want to add it. And I do use the pencil more like a mouse. So I use this a lot for that. And this 120 hertz display, if you don't have an iPad with that and you really enjoy using an iPad, it makes a huge difference, especially with scrolling and just doing everything. And then with iPad OS, you've got the same sort of haptic touch capability, although you don't feel anything because there's no haptic engine inside of this device. So hopefully the next version will have that, but you'll see. Looks pretty good. And that's it. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description. And if you have any other creative apps or things that you think I should try out, maybe games that are similar to what I have here, I'd love to hear what you have to say in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.